बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। होप यू ऑल स्टूडेंट्स विल बी फाइन। सो टुडेज टॉपिक इज मिसलेनियस बैक्टीरियल प्रोटीन सिंथेसिस। टुडेज लेक्चर इज शॉर्ट जस्ट लाइक माय प्रीवियस लेक्चर बिकॉज इट इज टेकन इन प्रैक्टिकल टाइम फ्रॉम 1:30 टू 2 PM। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट आर द लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ मिसलेनियस बैक्टीरियल प्रोटीन सिंथेसिस? Describe the mechanism of action, clinical uses and adverse effects of clindamycin and linzolate. Next, describe the mechanism of action, clinical uses and adverse effects of streptogramins. Next, the clinical uses of uric acid, polymyxins and mupirocin. Now, what is clindamycin? Clindamycin has a mechanism of action that is the same as that of erythromycin. Clindamycin, like that of macrolides, it binds to 50S ribosomal subunit and it blocks the transpeptidation step in the protein synthesis. I hope macrolides ka mechanism of action Dr. Maryam Rashid ne aapko detail mein karwaya hai ki wo kis tarah protein synthesis ke inhibition ko rokta hai. To its mechanism of action is same as that of macrolides. It binds to 50S ribosomal subunit and blocks the transpeptidation step in the synthesis of bacterial protein. Resistance mechanism are when concerned, they are the same as those for erythromycin, and cross resistance can also occur. Cross resistance means if the organism is resistant with erythromycin, then it should also be resistant to clindamycin. It is called cross resistance between the two drugs. Now, what are the mechanism of resistance of clindamycin? There may be methylation of binding site on 50S ribosomal subunit. When methylation of the binding site occurs, then the antibiotic, it will not bind to that site. Next, enzymatic inactivation. It means that some enzymes are formed from the bacteria which destroy or which inactivate the drug. Next, efflux pump mechanism. Certain pumps may be activated which do not allow the antibiotic to penetrate the organism, or which cause the antibiotic to get out of the bacteria, which is known as efflux pump. Now, the pharmacokinetics of clindamycin. Clindamycin is available in both IV and oral formulations, but use of the oral form is limited by gastrointestinal tolerance, as it is it cause gastrointestinal GIT irritation. So oral form is limited. It distributes well into all body fluids including bone, but it exhibits poor entry into cerebrospinal fluid. Clindamycin undergoes extensive hepatic or oxidative metabolism to inactive products, and it is excreted into bile as well as urine, but its excretion is more, it is primarily excreted into bile, while some portion is also excreted into urine. Low urinary elimination limits its clinical utility for urinary tract infections. Accumulation has been reported in patients with either severe renal impairment or hepatic failure. Now, the clinical uses of clindamycin. Clindamycin is used primarily in the treatment of infection caused by gram-positive organisms including methicillin resistant Staphylococcus aureus and Streptococcus and certain anaerobic bacteria. Gram-negative aerobes are resistant because of poor penetration of clindamycin through outer membrane. So it is used mainly in the treatment of infection caused by gram-positive organisms and certain anaerobic bacteria, treatment of anaerobes like bacteroids. It is also the backup drug against certain gram-positive cocci. It is also active against community-acquired strains of methicillin-resistant Staphylococcus aureus. It is also recommended for prophylaxis of endocarditis. It is active against pneumocystis gyrovectae. It is also used in combination with pyrimethamine for AIDS-related toxoplasmosis. Now, the adverse effects of clindamycin. Skin rashes, gastrointestinal irritation may occur with the use of drug. Neutropenia, hepatic dysfunction may occur with the use of clindamycin. In addition to skin rashes, the most common adverse effects is diarrhea, and diarrhea occurred due to the presence of serious pseudomembranous colitis. Why pseudomembranous colitis occur? Because it occurred due to overgrowth of Clostridium difficile. Oral administration of either metronidazole or vancomycin is usually effective in the treatment of Clostridium difficile. Next group is oxazolidinones. The drugs in this group are linzolid, redzolid, and torizolid. Linzolid is totally synthetic antibiotic. Linzolid is important group, and it is the clinical important that antibiotic is clinically very important when the patient is suspected having gram positive organ infection with gram positive organisms, and when other antibiotics are resistant, then linzolid in clinical setups nowadays, when other antibiotics are resistant against certain gram positive infection or infection caused by gram positive organisms, then linzolid is effective in this case. Vancomycin as well as linzolid, but now the organisms infection caused by vancomycin resistant organisms are increasing. So linzolid is very much important drug in this case, and meropenem is also very important. It is active against gram positive organisms including staphylococci, streptococci, enterococci, gram positive anaerobic cocci, and gram positive rods such as Cornbacterium species and Listeria monocytogenes. Now the mode of action or mechanism of action is that linzolid inhibits bacterial protein synthesis by binding to a unique site located on 23S ribosomal RNA of 50S ribosomal subunit near the interface with 30S. Thus the formation of initiation complex is prevented. Currently no cross resistance with other protein synthesis inhibitors. Resistance involves decreased affinity of linzolids for its binding site. Now the pharmacokinetics of linzolid, it is available in both oral and parenteral formulation. Oral bioavailability is 100%. Food does not interfere with the absorption of linzolid. It is metabolized in liver and excreted in urine. Half-life of linzolid is around about 4 to 6 hours. It has also post-antibiotic effect, which is around about 1.5 hours. Now the clinical uses of linzolid, it is the use in drug-resistant gram-positive cocci, including strains resistant to penicillin and vancomycin. Sorry, spelling mistake aa gayi hai, it is vancomycin. The drug is reserved for vancomycin-resistant Enterococcus faecium, methicillin resistant Staphylococcus aureus endocarditis, bacteremia, nosocomial and community acquired pneumonia caused by Staphylococcus aureus. So it is my personal observation. In some patients, when other antibiotic is resistant like vancomycin, penicillin, then in this case, in that case, linzolid is effective. And linzolid as well as meropenem and moxifloxacin. ठीक है, दीज थ्री एंटीबायोटिक्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो इसमें आपको मेरोपेनम तो लास्ट टाइम सेल वॉल सेंसेस इनहिबिटर्स में बताई थी. ठीक है, स्पेशली स्पेसिफिकली लिंजोलिड और मेरोपेनम वी विल यूज इन दैट केस व्हेन अदर एंटीबायोटिक आर रेजिस्टेंट टू सर्टेन माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स, एंड लिंजोलिड इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन केस ऑफ ग्राम पॉजिटिव ऑर्गेनिज्म. इट इज ऑल्सो एक्टिव अगेंस्ट लिस्टेरिया मोनोसाइटोजेंस एंड कॉर्नी बैक्टीरिया. Adverse effects of linzolid, it may lead to myelosuppression including anemia, leukopenia, pancytopenia and reversible thrombocytopenia, reversible neutropenia and reversible optic neuropathy. But neutropenia and optic neuropathy, it is reversible. When the drug is stopped, it will be finished. Now the drug interaction. Linzolid is reversible inhibitor of monoamine oxidase enzyme, and it may lead to cheese reaction with food containing tyramine, as it is inhibit the enzyme monoamine oxidase, and when it is consumed with the food containing cheese with a food containing high amount of tyramine, ठीक है, तो चीज रिएक्शन भी लगकर चीज रिएक्शन आप लोगों ने सिंपैथोमिमेटिक ड्रग्स में भी आपको करवाया था चीज रिएक्शन. जब मोनोमाइन ऑक्सीडेज की भी इनिबिशन हो जाएगी, साथ टायरामिन की मोनोमाइन ऑक्सीडेज की इनिबिशन की वजह से कीटाकोलोमिन्स का लेवल ज़्यादा होगा, और जब टायरामिन है वो कीटाकोलोमिन्स को रिलीज़ करवाती है, तो इस वजह से चीज़ रिएक्शन, इसका मतलब है कीटाकोलोमिन्स का लेवल ज़्यादा हो जाएगा, उसकी वजह से एडवर्स इफेक्ट्स आएंगे। ठीक है, इट मे आल्सो प्रेसिपिटेट सेरोटोनिन सिंड्रोम, लाइक सिम्टम्स ऑफ सेरोटोनिन सिंड्रोम कन्फ्यूजन, हाइपरटेंशन, सीजर्स, टैकीकार्डिया एंड मसल रिजिडिटी। एंड वाई इट इज कॉल्ड सेरोटोनिन सिंड्रोम, किस वजह से होता है, अगर हम इसको SSRIs के साथ यूज करें, सेरोटोनिन सेलेक्टिव सेरोटोनिन री अपटेक इनहिबिटर, जिसमें सेरोटोनिन की री अपटेक नहीं होती, अगर उसके साथ यूज़ करें तो मे कॉज सेरोटोनिन सिंड्रोम, क्योंकि ये एमए मोनोमाइन ऑक्सीडेज को इनहिबिट करता है। ठीक है, एज वेल एज जब हम इसको SSRIs के साथ लेंगे तो ये सेरोटोनिन का लेवल ज़्यादा कर देगा। ठीक है, इट में तो आप इन दोनों के साथ लिनजोलेट को देते हुए ये देखेंगे SSRIs के साथ नहीं लेना, और दूसरा के लिनजोलेट के होते हुए ऐसी कोई ऐसा फूड कंज्यूम नहीं करना जिसमें टायरामिन हो। नेक्स्ट ड्रग इज स्ट्रेप्टोग्रामिन्स। स्ट्रेप्टोग्रामिन्स इट इज़ ऑब्टेन्ड फ्रॉम स्ट्रेप्टोमाइसिस प्रेस्टीना स्पाइरालिस। इट्स अ सिनर्जिस्टिक कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ स्ट्रेप्टोग्रामिन बी क्यूनोप्रिस्टिन एंड स्ट्रेप्टोग्रामिन ए जेफोप्रिस्टिन इन अ 30:70 ratio। इट इज़ बैक्टीरियोसाइडल। मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एक्शन ऑफ दैट ड्रग, ईच कंपोनेंट ऑफ दिस कॉम्बिनेशन ड्रग बाइंड्स अ सेपरेट साइट ऑन द 50S बैक्टीरियल राइबोसोम। जेफोप्रिस्टिन डिस्टर्ब्स इलोंगेशन बाय इंटरफेयरिंग विद द एडिशन ऑफ न्यू अमीनो एसिड्स टू द पेप्टाइड चेन। क्यूनोप्रिस्टिन प्रिवेंट्स इलोंगेशन सिमिलर टू द मैक्रोलाइड्स एंड कॉजेज रिलीज ऑफ इनकम्प्लीट पेप्टाइड चेन्स। थस दे सिनर्जिस्टिकली इंटरप्ट द प्रोटीन सिंथेसिस। द कॉम्बिनेशन ड्रग इज बैक्टीरियोसाइडल एंड हैज अ लॉन्ग पोस्ट एंटीबायोटिक इफेक्ट। Pharmacokinetics, it is administered IV. The combination is rapidly metabolized by non-enzymatic reactions to active metabolites. The combination production may cause pain and it may lead to arthralgia. Clinical uses of streptogramins, its spectrum is similar to vancomycin and linezolid. It will cover the methicillin resistant Staphylococcus aureus. It is used in case of penicillin resistant pneumococci. Vancomycin resistant Staphylococcus aureus. It is also used for vancomycin resistant Enterococcus faecium. It is also used in skin infections of Staphylococcus aureus and also used in case of nosocomial pneumonia. Now the mechanism of resistance of Streptogramus. E. faecalis is resistant to that drug due to efflux transport system. Either methylation of target site of ribosome occur or enzymatic inactivation, that is some enzymes are formed from the bacteria which destroy the or which inactivate the antibiotic. Adverse effects, pain at the injection site may occur, which leads to arthralgia, myalgia syndrome. They are potent inhibitors of CYP3A4, increased plasma levels of many drugs including sisoprolide, cyclosporine and warfarin. Now the next drug is mupirocin. Mupirocin inhibits bacterial RNA and protein synthesis. It binds to isoleucine transfer RNA synthetase. This prevents incorporation of isoleucine into the bacterial protein synthesis. It inhibits bacterial protein synthesis but by elongation of peptide chain. Antibacterial spectrum for mupirocin includes especially staphylococci and streptococci organism. Now its clinical uses, topical antibiotic is used for skin infection. It is also used in case of methicillin resistant Staphylococcus aureus, especially in the nose when this infection occurs, especially topical in the nose. It is used in case of impetigo and folliculitis. Adverse effects of that drug, itchiness and rash may occur at the site of application. Next drug is Spectinomycin. Spectinomycin is an antibiotic which is produced by Streptomyces spectabilis. Mode of action is that it selectively inhibits protein synthesis in gram-negative bacteria. The antibiotic binds to an exon 30S ribosomal subunit. Its action is similar to that of minoglycosides, but spectinomycin is not bactericidal and does not cause misreading of messenger RNA. As aminoglycoside is bacteriocided, but spectrumycin is not bactericided. It binds to 30S ribosomal subunit and inhibits protein synthesis. Its only therapeutic use is in the treatment of gonorrhea caused by strain resistant to first-line drugs. And it is specifically important, that drug is specifically important in gram-negative bacteria. Adverse effects of that drug may, with the use of this drug, may occur urticaria, chills, and fever. Resistance, bacterial resistance may occur by mutations in the 16S ribosomal RNA or a modification of the drug by adenyl transferase enzyme. Next drug is fusidic acid. It interferes with protein synthesis by interfering with peptide chain. Inhibit translocation step in protein synthesis. So it interferes with peptide chain elongation factor G and inhibit the translocation step. It is bacteriostatic. It is used as creams and the form of creams and eye drops. It is effective against gram-positive bacteria, especially streptococcus. It is particularly active against penicillinase producing Staphylococcus aureus, cornibacterium, and Clostridium. It is highly lipid-soluble agent. It irritates the skin. It is used for boils, impetigo, and pyoderma. It is also used for the treatment of acne vulgaris. Now the assignment for today, enumerate clinical uses of clindamycin. Polymyxin and colistin. It's the peptide antibiotics. These are very toxic. Polymyxin, it's not absorbed from the gastrointestinal tract. Colistin is polymyxin E. Colistin sulfate, it is reserved for oral use, and colistin methanate sodium, it is used as parenteral use. Now the mode of action, polymyxin B and colistin function as cationic detergents and disrupts the bacterial cell membrane osmotic integrity by displacing calcium and magnesium from membrane lipid phosphates. The clinical uses, it is mainly effective against Pseudomonas, it is effective against Enterobacter, E. coli, other gram-negative bacteria. But due to its toxicity, it is mostly used as topical form, like creams or drops, to treat otitis externa or as a component of triple antibiotic ointment like skin infections. Adverse effects include neurotoxicity, paresthesias, ataxia, and slurred speech, nephrotoxicity, hematuria, proteinuria, and tuberculosis. So due to all these adverse effects, its use is limited to only topical use.